Hey, Matt 31, I had a question coming out of section 2.7, number 13. We were asked to solve this inequality. Now there's a couple ways you could start this. You could multiply every term in this inequality by the LCD and knock out the fractions. So let me just start you on that path and then I'll show you the work that I actually did over here. So if we take a look at this, let me get this going. The LCD for these three denominators here, the LCD is 40. So what you could do is you could multiply every term in that inequality by 40. And if you want to do that, it would probably look a little bit simpler than all of this shenanigans over here, but I still want to go through the shenanigans just to show you. So the 8 and the 40 would divide out and give you a 5. So I would have 5 times x plus 3 here. The 40 and the 5 would divide out and leave you with an 8. So I would have 8 minus 8 times x plus 5, right? And then the 40 and the 10 would cancel out, and this would be greater than or equal to 12. So you could then solve this inequality and get to the end. But I still want to go through how you could do this, keeping the fraction. So let me erase what we have here, although I am going to just rewrite that the LCD here is 40. Just because I think we get scared of fractions, right? At least I've seen it in the past where students are scared of fractions. So I just want to practice fractions. So if I want to practice fractions, whenever you want to add or subtract fractions, you need a common denominator. And that common denominator in this case is 40. So what I need to do to each term is multiply by a very special version of 1. And here's what I mean. If my first denominator is 8, I would need to multiply that denominator by 5 to get to 40, and I got to balance that out in the numerator. If I look at my second denominator, it's 5, so I'm going to multiply numerator and denominator by 8. All right, and over here, I've got a 10, so I'm going to multiply numerator and denominator by 4. And then what that creates is each of these denominators are 40, right? 5 times 8 is 40. 8 times 5 is 40. 10 times 4 is 40. And the bonus to that is once you have common denominators, you can add and subtract fractions. So let me just do a sidestep here so that we can see what's happening. I have 5 times x plus 3 over 40 minus 8 times x plus 5 over 40 equaling 12 over 40. All right, and then because these are common denominators, I can just clump the numerators together. So if I clump, I know that's a nice technical term, if I clump the numerators together, I'm looking at 5 times x plus 3 minus 8 times x plus 5 all over 40 is greater than or equal to 12. Oh, I'm just noticing I put an equal sign here. This should be a greater than or equal to. Oops, why is that? Sometimes that happens. I don't know why. Let me fix what I got. Give me one moment. This would have been greater than or equal to, and we would have had, what, a 12, oops, over 40. All right, I'm caught up. So we're getting closer. Now, if we take a look, it looks like there's some scribbles here. Let me get rid of them. If we take a look at where we are so far, all right, we're right around here, and you might be saying, well, why is there this 8x plus 40 and this 5x plus 15? Well, that's because I would have distributed, right? So if I distribute the 5 to the x plus 3, that's going to get me 5x plus 15. If I distribute the 8 to the x plus 5, that is going to get me x plus 40. But the thing you have to remember is I do have, let me change the highlighter color, I do have this negative here. So I need to distribute that negative to the 8x and to the 40. And I think that's probably easier seen over here. So let me go one step further with this. This would have been 5x plus 15 minus 8x minus 40. And that would have been over 40 is greater than or equal to 12 over 40, right? So when I start to collect like terms, and let me get different colors up, 5x minus 8x is negative 3x, right? And then let me go purple, positive 15 minus 40 is negative 25. So that's where those numbers are coming from. So I get negative 3x minus 25 is greater than over 40 is greater than or equal to 12 over 40. So I'm at this step, that's why I started. I'm going to multiply both sides by 40, and the denominators will cancel out, and that's going to get me to negative 3x minus 25 is greater than or equal to 12. Now, I had fun and factored out a negative. I think what most of you will do is do negative 3x minus 25 is greater than or equal to 12. You'll add 25 to both sides, right? And you're going to, let me not drop the negative. You'll have negative 3x is greater than or equal to positive 37. I'm going to divide by negative 3. And then we'll keep in mind, when we divide by a negative, we have to change the direction of the inequality. And if I think about this on the number line, I'm looking at negative 37 over 3. I want a closed dot. And the reason I want a closed dot is because that symbol is less than or equal to. I want to shade all the way to the left. And if I shade all the way to the left, that means I'm going all the way down to negative infinity. But when we write our intervals up, we always go low to high, which is why I have negative infinity to negative 37 thirds. And that's my solution for that. And this, again, all of this is using fractions. If you don't like fractions, solve this inequality right here. All right, after I multiplied every term by the LCD, you're going to get the same answer. All right, thanks so much, everyone. Bye.